Hello guys, welcome to Amit Thinks. In this video, we will learn how to install PostgreSQL on Windows 10. We will also create a sample database. Let us start. At first, go to the web browser. On Google, type PostgreSQL and press enter. On pressing enter, the official website is visible, postgresql.org. Click on it. Here is the official website. Now directly click the download button. Here different installers are visible. We want for Windows, so I'll click here. Here is the installer. You need to click on this file. This will include the PostgreSQL server. It will also include pgadmin, which is a tool to manage your databases. It will also include Stack Builder, which is a package manager for PostgreSQL tools and drivers. So I'll just click the installer. Now different versions are visible. We want for Windows x86-64. That is the following Windows 10 system. So I'll just click here to download. Now the download will start. Here it is. 344 MB. Let's wait. Guys, we have successfully downloaded the exe file. Right click and click open to. Begin the installation, minimize. The setup started, click next. Installation directory is the following, keep it as it is and click next. Select components, it will install the server, pgadmin, stack builder as well as command line tools. Keep it as it is and click next. Data directory, it is a place where your databases will get saved. So the following is the path. Keep it as it is and click next. Add a password for your database super user. Add any password and click next. Port number is the following. Keep it as it is and click next. Select the locale. I'll type E so that I can reach English. Here it is. Okay. After that, click next. Click next. Click next. And the installation will start. Let's wait. Guys, we have successfully installed. Now it will finish the installation and launch Stack Builder also. But I'll just uncheck this and click finish. Now let us start PostgreSQL and create a new database. Go to start. Type pgadmin. It's visible here. Click open. Pgadmin started. So here click servers. We clicked on servers and our default database is visible. To create a new database, right click on databases, click create, click database and add the database name. Let's say I'll add a database name as student and rest I'll keep the default and click save. So we created a student database here. You can see now two databases. So student database created successfully. For free tutorials, refer to the links in the description of the video.